First, ISIS took Fallujah, then ISIS took Mosul, and ISIS had taken Ramadi. So is President Obama now rethinking his strategy? We're hearing the U.S. is now planning to speed up the training and equipping of Sunni fighters to fight ISIS. And joining us, the first female fighter pilot, Congresswoman Martha McSally. Nice to see you.
Good to see you again.
So the president says that they are, quote, speeding up training for the Sunni groups. I don't know what speeding up means, but your thoughts on this.
Well, I was just over in the region a couple weeks ago on a congressional delegation getting briefings from our military leadership, and I'm deeply concerned about their will to fight. And
I mean, our will to fight?
No, the Iraqis' will to fight.
Okay.
You look at in Mosul and you look at in Ramadi, they severely outnumbered the opposition. They were in defensive positions, and they basically ran. And we've got our advisory teams on the ground because of the Obama administration's limitations, literally, like, talking to them on the phone.
Well,
trying to tell them, like, no, don't run. This is what you need to do, because we're not allowed to use the capabilities that we have to even allow them to militarily do what they need to do. So it's a very failed policy.
I take it's very hard to, quote, train will.
Right.
I mean, will's got to be sort of, you know, you either have the fire in your belly or you don't.
Right. And it comes to a deeper issue of the political solution is not there. We need a reconciliation in the government where the Sunnis are really included. We've got Iran increasing its influence in the region while we're continuing to negotiate with them, you know, on the nuclear deal. And so, you know, the Sunnis are looking at it like, well, what's in it for us? And so the will to fight, you know, comes for a lot of different reasons. For those of us who served in the military, you know, sometimes it's that larger patriotic, you know, reason, or the mission in front of you, or the guy next to you. You're trying to fight for them, but they have none of that right now.
But shouldn't Baghdad have the will to fight with the Sunnis? I mean, we're not seeing the Sunnis in the Arab regions and the Shia in Baghdad. How do they get the combined will to fight together?
Well, this is part of the challenge, but again, it starts with the political solution. If the Sunnis feel deeply undermined in the government, they don't know what's coming next. Now have Shia militias that are, you know, moving into the Sunni areas because they're needing somebody to be fighting there. And so if we're looking at just the tactical issues only and not looking at the larger strategic, like, what's the end game here?
So what should President Obama do? I mean, how can he get them to fight?
He needs to, first of all, have a coherent strategy for the region that is addressing Iran's state sponsor of terror marching towards a nuclear weapon and wanting to be the regional hegemon, a serious political solution in Iraq that somehow is inclusive, and we're not contradicting ourselves in one part of the region with another part of the region. You know, then we have to have a comprehensive military strategy that uses military power for what we bring to the fight. We need to be using our air power much more extensively. We need to be embedding special forces and JTACs on the ground to call in airstrikes. We need our advisors to at least be alongside and not on the phone. We've got to provide the space to destroy ISIS's capabilities so there can be a political solution. And right now we're doing that in a very anemic way.
Do you think that the president is talking with his military leaders and heeding their advice?
It's hard to tell. Again, I was meeting with some of the military leaders while I was over there, and given the direction and the strategy that they have been handed, they feel that they are doing everything that they have been told, but obviously they're getting the guidance from the White House down. So given the very limited objectives that they've been asked to achieve at the operational level, they're doing what they can. We've got artificial boots on the ground limitations that are also impacting our ability to use air power, combat search and rescue in the ways that we need to. So this is really a flawed operational and military strategy, as well as a flawed regional political strategy.
Congresswoman, thanks for joining us. Hope to come back.
Sure. Thanks for having me on. And after the